The WWE Universe with an electric feeling here tonight. We are sold out and raring to go.
I am amped up, pumped up, jacked up, and ready to kick things off. What are we waiting for, fellas? Let's watch some fights.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are here for WWE Clash of Champions Gold Rush. Every match is a championship match here tonight. So we got Finn Balor versus AJ Styles for the United States title on Raw. Becky Lynch challenges Bianca Belair for the women's title. Drew McIntyre won the Elite Eight matchup on SmackDown to face Rey Mysterio tonight for the Intercontinental title. Sasha Banks got a revenge on Bayley, earned the right to face Charlotte for the Divas Championship. Riddle, who won the six-pack elimination challenge at Payback to earn his right. He went through Brock Lesnar and all the chain attempts that Brock Lesnar had at him. He will face Triple H for the WWE Championship. Undertaker came and won a four-team tag team matchup for the number one contender spot, so it would be the Brothers of Destruction versus the Hart Foundation. Rivalry that's been ensued, Kofi Kingston challenges Edge for the World Heavyweight Championship. In the big main event, the Outsiders challenge the Usos for the SmackDown Tag Team titles. Hulk Hogan, Hollywood Hogan, in the Outsiders corner for the NWO, and Roman Reigns alongside his cousins in the Bloodline. So it's a great night of action. Should be interesting. Let's get Clash of the Champions Gold Rush underway.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the WWE United States Championship.
The Prince has arrived.
A decorated champion who has truly reinvented himself.
This is a man who is already one of the greatest NXT superstars in history, but truly cemented his legacy by returning and dominating as NXT champion once again.
Well, now he's set to dominate any roster that Finn Balor targets.
You know, I don't know if it's just me, or does Finn Balor just keep getting cooler every year?
Saxton, when it comes to being cool, you are one man I will never ask. You can see the intense focus and drive in the eyes of Finn Balor.
When it comes to Finn Balor, it's always about competing at the highest of levels.
You are looking at a one-of-a-kind superstar. Former Intercontinental Champion, United States Champion, WWE Champion, plenty of hardware to back up his success. From where they've been in their career to where they are today, this indeed a dream match between AJ Styles and Finn Balor. He is the consummate in-ring competitor.
Well, AJ Styles is a great competitor, but hardly professional.
Come on, Byron, you can't argue with AJ's success.
Introducing the challenger, from Bray, County Wicklow, Ireland, weighing in at 190 pounds, Finn Balor! And introducing the champion, from Gainesville, Georgia, weighing in at 218 pounds, he is the WWE United States Champion, the
This is all for the highly decorated United States Championship.
Harley Race, the inaugural champion, truly a tough man's title.
All right, here we go to kick off Clash of the Champions, AJ Styles, Finn Balor for the United States Championship.
Tonight, this match is about the future. The United States champion isn't focused on how he won it. He's focused on keeping it.
As much as I want to, I can't argue with that, Corey. Oh, Balor with the counter. Oh, man, right to the arm.
Hyperextend your elbow
to the arm.
And Finn Balor connected nicely there.
Rocked his opponent.
Sky high. Splash! Forced out of the ring. And countouts are legal, so hopefully this will be a short trip outside. Few competitors are as precise in the ring as Finn Balor. Corey, how do you think that benefits Balor tonight?
A precise superstar is a dangerous superstar, Cole, and Balor's more than aware of that. As long as Finn can maintain precision and avoid mistakes, Balor has a strong chance of winning this one.
Momentum here. Styles really not letting up on Balor here at all.
Six.
Taking this one back to the ring now.
Look at him. Seven. Pride and poise personified.
Eight.
Taking it outside the ring now.
The adrenaline is pumping, and the WWE Universe is on his side.
Here comes Styles.
The Phenomenal One is holding nothing back.
Balor able to stop the blitz that was coming his way.
Could be what Balor needed to ignite a rally.
Ooh, dropped right on their face.
Oh, he's got him in deep, deep trouble here. Look out. Slick shot right across the back of the neck.
Ouch.
AJ Styles rolls through. Here it comes. Nice job getting the ropes.
Really had no choice.
He's got him in the crosshairs.
Styles connects.
I think the champ's got him.
Makes a cover.
1, 2, 3. And AJ Styles remains the champ.
Phenomenal. Here is your winner, and still the WWE United States Champion.
Look, there is no embarrassment in coming up short to the phenomenal AJ Styles.
I second that. A great effort by Finn Balor, who was just not extraordinary enough tonight.
Great win for AJ Styles to retain the United States Champion here at Clash of the Champions in a great kickoff match. It was a good match to start off. Up next, ladies and gentlemen, it is the Women's Championship. Bianca Belair defends her Women's Championship against Becky Lynch, which should be a fantastic match here tonight at Clash of the Champions.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the WWE Women's Championship.
Here comes the man.
The WWE Universe on its feet for Becky Lynch.
The man has an unmatched confidence and swagger about herself.
Becky's about to stake her claim as the man.
Yeah, I don't see her claim being denied here tonight.
Became the first women's double champion when she beat Charlotte Flair at WrestleMania.
Yeah, but every once in a while, that much confidence can be detrimental, especially when you're a target. Everyone wants to make a name off of the man.
She calls herself the EST.
Cole Byron's like the EST of the commentary team.
The worst,
the dumbest, the ugliest.
Hey, those are dumb examples. Watch what you say.
There is just a different energy when the EST is here. A spectacular athlete, former star, track and weightlifting, Bianca Belair has next level stamina and power inside the ring.
Without question, one of the absolute best in the women's division.
Yeah.
Introducing the challenger from Dublin, Ireland, Becky Lynch. And introducing the champion from Knoxville, Tennessee, she is the WWE Women's Champion, Bianca Belair.
Lots of competitors in the back dream for a shot at this title.
All right, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The Women's Championship on the line on Raw as Becky Lynch challenges Bianca Belair here at Clash of the Champions.
Becky Lynch has never met a fight she didn't like. She's told the locker room to bring their A-game.
And Bianca Belair, known as the EST of WWE, if you find yourself wondering exactly what that means, it's probably because you've never been the best at anything in your life.
Talking to you, Byron. Becky Lynch with a great shot, looking for a high-risk move. From the top,
elbow drop, good lord.
Here's the pin, title on the line.
One, two.
And she kicks out at two.
We'll see if this is the start of a rally.
And Bianca turning around. She returns the favor there.
Great job refocusing to reverse that.
Planted face first.
Becky Lynch has often thrown caution to the wind. Corey, will that benefit her tonight?
Some will say that this is the reason Lynch has had so much success, but I feel tonight she has to take a more measured approach. Patience will be the key for Becky tonight.
One might do it.
Oh, get ready. She knows exactly what she's doing with this submission hold. Good job getting the ropes there. Yeah, that could have been bad.
This might be the beginning of the end.
Oh, manhandle slam.
And into the count.
Two.
Oh, by a hair.
She got so close, she could taste it there.
She gets Becky with a counter.
Double chicken wing up and slam, slam.
And Belair is making a statement right there.
Top left. 50 splash. Can it be? Will the rain continue?
A kick out. I don't believe it.
This puts the pressure back on the champion.
Can the champion respond with their back against the wall?
Belair has to be contemplating her next step now. If that was her plan A, she needs to move to plan B.
Back suplex.
She turns it right around with a counter.
In full control here. Face full of turnbuckle. Using the bottom rope, springboard sidekick connects.
Oh, look at that. Embracing her adoring public. Tossed into the corner.
Boom! Bodies must be writhing in pain right now. The breaking point must be on the horizon.
But yet they continue forward, showing no desire to quit.
Belair now trying to capitalize.
Finds the advantage after a string of counters.
Down with a suplex.
Ooh!
Bianca is certainly fighting from behind now.
And that's Becky being patient.
See? Lynch. He's got a cinched in the disorder.
Locked in. This will break your arm in a hurry. Can Becky's opponent hang?
There it is. Becky Lynch shuts down all uncertainty. She is now champion.
What a battle. Respect to both competitors.
And this I love. This I absolutely love. Maybe you should have taken a page out of that kid's book in your career, Corey. Great sportsmanship.
Well, congratulations to Becky Lynch becoming the new Raw Women's Champion here tonight at Clash of the Champions, making Bianca Belair tap out. Could be a great rivalry on Monday Night Raw for sure. Great match between these two. Alright, up next, ladies and gentlemen, will be the Intercontinental Championship as Drew McIntyre will challenge Rey Mysterio here at Clash of the Champions.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the WWE Intercontinental Championship.
This man is a real force, Drew McIntyre. His first time in WWE, in his words, was a failure. He could not reach expectations.
Yeah, but Drew McIntyre left WWE. He proved himself and then returned to become a champion and a main event level talent here in WWE. The look of confidence on the face of Drew McIntyre says it all. He's about to do what he loves to do most, and that's get in a fight.
Now this is going to be good.
Without a doubt, one of the greatest Lucha Libre stars in sports entertainment history.
Break out your notepads because we are about to receive a masterclass in high flying.
One of the all-time greats. Listen to the ovation for the biggest little man in the history of WWE, Rey Mysterio.
You gotta love an underdog story like Rey Mysterio's.
It sounds nice, but I wouldn't know. I've never been an underdog in my life.
Introducing the challenger from Ayr, Scotland, weighing in at 254 pounds, Drew McIntyre. And introducing the champion from San Diego, California, weighing in at 175 pounds, he is the WWE Intercontinental Champion, Rey Mysterio!
You win this title, you are a top name in this industry.
Here you go, Rey Mysterio, Drew McIntyre representing SmackDown, looking to put on a great show here at Clash of Champions for the Intercontinental Championship.
The legendary luchador Rey Mysterio is looking fired up, and you can tell this is going to be one of those matches where Rey is going to go 100 miles per hour.
Now, you can put the speedometer away because Rey's going to break it. The big question is he going to run right into a brick wall?
All we know is Mysterio is going to go at full speed no matter what the situation.
But tonight, he clashes with Drew McIntyre, a seasoned superstar who returned to WWE after a global wrestling journey where he saw it all and won it all.
Yeah, Drew's grappling with the very best talents all over the planet, but he came back here to prove that he has what it takes to hang with the toughest competition that there is. Mysterio's success is not limited to a division or type of competition. Quote, how has Mysterio made a career of defeating opponents of all shapes and sizes?
Mysterio's reinvented his training regimen, so the emphasis on cardio, flexibility, and core strength. Mysterio's ability to adapt on the ground and in the air are second to none.
From the top, double axe handle connects. Getting tossed around.
Oh, that might have just broken something.
Insulting.
Beat the side. Jeez.
Rey moves out of trouble.
And another counter. The champ getting put to the test here.
Well, Rey Mysterio successfully retains the Intercontinental Championship here tonight at Clash of the Champions over Drew McIntyre. An interesting match to start. Alright, up next, ladies and gentlemen, Sasha Banks versus Charlotte Flair for the Divas Championship over on SmackDown. Charlotte Flair has not lost a match for her title since she became the champion back at Backlash, or Money in the Bank, I believe.
The following contest is scheduled for one. WWE Divas Championship.
It's boss time. Byron, it's always a treat to see Sasha Banks.
Sasha Banks has her own swag. She's got her own confidence, and she knows how to back it up.
If there's a camera around, Sasha wants to be in front of it. If there's a spotlight out, she wants to be in the middle of it. Sasha Banks once stood in line for the opening of a refrigerator. You should get one of those rings that say Graves on it like Sasha has.
I'll pass.
Here comes the queen, the franchise, and the self-proclaimed opportunity.
You know, the WWE Universe, at least many in it, believe that she's been handed title opportunities in main events.
Well, many of those same doubters live in their parents' basements, Cole. I wouldn't necessarily value their opinion. This is Charlotte Flair. This is the queen. This is the opportunity.
So, Byron, from your parents' basement, what do you feel about Charlotte Flair?
First of all, I moved out last week, Michael. And second of all, I do think Charlotte's ego can be a bit out of control at times.
After everything Charlotte Flair has accomplished in her career, her ego is allowed to be as big as it possibly can be.
She's got an amazing robe.
Saxton, how have you not learned by now? You need to open the ropes for the queen.
Corey, haven't you heard? I'm no longer on robe duty.
I didn't get that memo.
Introducing the challenger from Boston, Massachusetts, Sasha Banks. And introducing the champion from the Queen City. She is the WWE Divas Champion, Charlotte
The historic Divas title may have a new owner tonight.
Sasha versus Charlotte for the Divas Championship here on SmackDown.
The Divas title was the pinnacle for women's wrestling, and it's back up for grabs tonight.
Now, Michael, you and I were there on the final defense of this title at Roadblock in 2016, and I am excited to call it again right here tonight.
From the middle of the media! Oh, it's a kick to the spine. Oh, man, right to the arm.
Hyperextend your elbow.
Trying to chop her down with a low kick. And she's a step ahead of Banks. Elbow smash. The boss, Sasha Banks, has become renowned for her ring IQ over the years. Corey, will that benefit her here tonight?
Absolutely, Cole. I'll even admit that Banks is a genius when that bell rings. And she's never better than when she embraces that very fact.
The Queen Suplex.
Oh, foot just stomping down. Stomp right to the belly.
Banks had that well scouted.
Here it comes.
And shoulders are down.
She just shocked everyone in the ring.
Look at this, Byron.
Looking to apply pressure.
Think about all of them.
Slipped through and escaped. That was pretty. Oh, and a knee.
And another.
Endless knee strikes.
And she gets herself out of a precarious position. She's got to be careful here. The referee will count her out.
Isolating the arm.
Flair now is dictating the pace.
Oh, you hate to see Sasha like this.
Might take her head clean off her shoulders. The boss keeping focus.
And she's using this moment to summon all of her strength.
Answering back.
Sequence of reversals there.
She's trying to create space.
Inverted backbreaker.
Ow. A bad place to be for the challenger.
And this match is not over yet. Things are only going to get better from here.
Something in the corner.
Wrist lock. Climbing the ropes. Into the arm.
Here's a pin for the title.
1, 2.
Champ with the shoulder up.
Just barely, but it counts.
Snapping the neck.
She won't tap. Not here. Not now.
Up and up. Face buster.
Man, the boss avoids the attack.
Here it comes.
Nicely done.
Mat slam.
With some attitude.
Ooh, well planted knee.
Ouch.
Oh, my God. Oh, God. The champ's not looking great right now. Not a bad place to be in, but the longer this goes, the more trouble a superstar exposes himself to.
Coming into the cover with the title.
New champion. New champion.
He got it.
New champ.
turn of events.
One reign ends and another begins.
What a stunning moment. These superstars gave everything they had, but the new champ wanted it just a little bit more.
Charlotte Flair has been dethroned. Sasha Banks, the new Divas Champion on SmackDown. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. WWE Championship on the line. Matt Riddle won the six-pack elimination match at Payback to earn his right. He's gone through multiple challenges from Brock Lesnar, but he will face Triple H for the WWE Championship tonight at Clash of the Champions.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the WWE Championship.
Also, somehow, one of the most relaxed guys in the business outside of the ring. All business inside of it.
I like Riddle. I like his swag. I think I can learn a thing or two from him.
It's not going to make you any cooler.
The flops are off, and that means Riddle is ready.
We're about to see a grappling clinic.
This is gonna be good.
WWE Universe, it's time to play the game.
Make no mistake about it, the King of Kings is here.
Nobody possesses a higher in-ring IQ than the Cerebral Assassin.
Well, think about it. Every tactic, every trick, every technique you can think of, Triple H has mastered.
You know, the game will stop at nothing. He'll use every tool at his disposal to win the matchup. That is why he has become maybe the greatest of all time. The creator of the pedigree, a truly devastating move.
Yeah, and he's mastered how, when, and where to utilize it.
Yeah, the pedigree almost always guarantees the end for Triple H's opponent.
I guarantee Triple H already has plans on when to use it tonight.
Introducing the challenger from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing in at 216 pounds, Riddle. And introducing the champion from Greenwich, Connecticut, weighing in at 255 pounds, he is the WWE Champion, The King, Triple H.
A title coveted by legends and hungry young talent alike.
Riddle won the opportunity at Payback to face Triple H tonight, gone through obstacles, Brock Lesnar, and more. Triple H's first pay-per-view back since the incredible 60-minute Iron Man match with Stone Cold, in which he retired Austin back at SummerSlam. Triple H Riddle for the WWE Championship underway.
Quite nicely into his role as CEO of WWE, but every once in a while he gets the itch to lace up boots and return to the ring. Cole, if I didn't know any better, it's always exciting to see a legend like Triple H grace us with his presence. Having the King of Kings around is certainly what's best for business.
I can't argue with the fact that any match involving Triple H is a big one.
And staring him down is Riddle, the original bro. Byron, I'll emphasize original because there's nothing stale about Riddle. His style, his attitude, his in-ring abilities are completely his own and completely fresh. Others can try to pretend, but Matt Riddle is living it. Neckbreaker! Right in the mouth, relentless.
Enough already.
Uh-oh, position in.
Measuring. Oh, knee drop.
Woo!
The original bro taking some hits there. His perched up top. Nobody hold on that.
Still a lot of game left here.
Power for the suplex. Riddle has a non-stop motor in the ring. His ability to maintain a high energy level throughout a long, strenuous match is pretty intimidating. Does that make speed the key to defeating Riddle?
That would certainly help.
You have to hit Riddle early and try to beat him fast before he tires you up. The question is, can you do the damage required to stop Riddle in short order?
Riddle turns that around.
Knee strike
on the jaw,
taking this match off the mat now.
Here we go.
Hammer strike.
Oh, stomping away.
Oh my God, what an elbow. He deflects it right back.
Simply refusing to stay down.
Keeping in close quarters, and look at these lefts.
This is just a ruthless attack.
Oh, such aggression.
Oh, and he stays ahead of Triple H. Specifically targeting the leg.
Uh-oh, this is not going to look pretty. Submission being applied.
Now trying to submission. This
needs to find a way out of the triangle.
The left hands will do it. He's free. Yeah. Oh,
stepping things up a little bit. The superstar starting to build.
Here it comes.
Right at this point, blow after blow.
Now a pin for the championship. Champion.
I mean, you gotta think he's just one final blow away from not kicking out next time.
Foot meet back. I don't like the look in his eye here, folks.
Taking flight.
Hooked. The champ will stay champ for the win.
two count.
Oh, he gets the shoulder up before three.
It was almost just lights out on their championship dreams.
Let's see if that kick out was a spark, or is it the challenger's last gasp?
Cerebral assassin.
Riddle's got something big in mind.
He switches it back.
Lift off.
Diving in hammer. Shoulders down. Kimmy's on the line.
Two.
No, he gets the shoulder up.
He refuses to stay down.
Pure instinct.
The original bro looking to end this.
Resilience of a champion on display.
And Riddle's laid back demeanor is starting to crack after that kick out. Oh, a step up in Ziggy. Look at this.
Effectively targeting the arm.
The game is one step ahead.
Triple H counters.
Banging back with their own counter.
Up and down, what a cord buster.
And Riddle takes a nasty looking offense there.
Yeah, Triple H must know the time for playing around is over now.
For the win to retain the championship.
One, two.
Kick out of the title fight continues.
This is insanity.
Did you expect anything less?
Here is your winner, and still the WWE Champion, The Game, Triple H.
That was a difficult win,
but it was a big win in the record books.
Triple H remains the king.
What a match between Triple H and Riddle. Riddle came out, put on a show, gave Triple H everything he could handle. But the game still your WWE champion here at the Clash of the Champions. What a match that was. Back and forth. And up next, ladies and gentlemen, it will be the Raw Tag Team Titles. Up next, the Brothers of Destruction, Undertaker and Kane challenge Bret Hart and Jim the Anvil Neidhart, the Hart Foundation. Bret Hart has made both Undertaker and Kane tap out to the sharpshooter. Will it happen tonight again at Clash of Champions?
The Brothers of Destruction.
What started as a bitter sibling rivalry has turned into a dominant tag team.
Maybe the most dominant tag team we've ever seen.
We'll be right back.
It's the Hart Foundation.
Boys in Destruction looking for the tag team gold. The Hart Foundation is not lost since winning the gold months ago. Can they retain the titles here tonight? Bret Hart has made both Undertaker and Kane tap out to the sharpshooter in recent weeks. What's going to happen tonight here at the Clash of the Champions for the Raw tag team titles?
Intestinal fortitude, because the World Tag Team Championships are up for grabs in this team competition. On one side, we see
sleeper hold cinched in too close to the ropes.
Yep, and the hold is broken.
Just breaking down the opponent. Carefully measured knee drop.
Return fire from the Undertaker. Setting him up for the shin breaker.
Gonna be hard to walk after that.
Look at this. Thunder lights. Looking for a high risk, high reward situation. From the top. The challenger's looking shaken. Clean tag for his partner. Power slam.
Boom, right across the small of the back.
Kane gets that set right back to him.
Woo-hoo! DDT.
Competitors showing they've done their homework.
Get him into the corner.
Kane gets out of the way. DDT delivered.
So much damage inflicted.
He's one step ahead there. Carried around with ease. Down on the windpipe.
And a claw. There's the claw. This could be it. He's got locked in.
And breaks the hold, but damage has been done.
Bruising attack to the stomach.
The challenger eating up some damage. He made it. Tag made.
Been planted.
Oh, hard impact in the corner. Boom, what a right.
Dismantling the arm in the corner.
Gotta hurt. I've always said it, best cure striker in the history of WWE.
Taker just unleashing. What's he gonna do?
Ooh.
does.
Somehow he saw Taker coming.
From the Hitman.
Oh my God. Oh, backbreaker.
Right to the spine.
Oh no, getting in position. What's he planning to do here?
I think he's got it locked in good. I just don't know how to counter this thing. A single leg camel clutch and a great counter. Knew it was coming from Taker.
This could be the beginning of the end.
Uh-oh. The Hitman. And he makes it to the ropes. For the championship.
Coming to the rescue.
Stomping. Ouch.
Undertaker saw it coming.
Here we go. In front of DDT. Lights out. Look out.
Ooh.
Drop kicked all the way to the floor.
For the tag.
Hopped up. No way.
Yes way.
What power.
Stone. The champ's eyes look glazed over.
Is it enough? The cover.
Two. Hitman expected that.
I can't believe it.
We were finally home
from a new champ.
Are we close to the start of a new reign?
The Undertaker is now realizing that his opponent refuses to rest in peace.
What a battle we are witnessing.
We're at a stage where someone's going to have to shift it into another gear.
Some hard offense landing on the champ.
Yeah, they stuck it out through this match, but it wouldn't hurt to go for the tag soon here.
Undertaker and Kane, the Brothers of Destruction.
A night and title change we will all remember for a very long time.
I thought the defending champion had this well in hand, but the new champ had other plans.
It just goes to show you anything can happen in WWE.
Jinden Anvil Neidhart taps out. Irony that the Hart Foundation lose the submission after Bret Hart had the Brothers of Destruction tap out to the Sharpshooter the last few weeks. With that being said, Undertaker and Kane, the new Raw Tag Team Champions, here tonight at the Clash of Champions. Up next, ladies and gentlemen, the World Heavyweight Championship on the line. The only person to defeat Edge about three weeks ago on SmackDown was Kofi Kingston. Edge got even by spearing Kofi during one of his matches, solo matches. And now Kofi is looking to become the World Heavyweight Champion here at Clash of the Champions.
The following contest is scheduled for one-of-a-kind competitor, the often imitated, never duplicated, Kofi Kingston.
The nearly bottomless energy of Kofi Kingston, it's infectious, guys.
He's told anyone who will listen that he always has been the uncrowned champion of this division. Now he can make it a reality.
The ultimate opportunist. Byron, here's a superstar who really is living his dream.
Cornerstone, one of the forefathers of the tables, ladders, and chairs match.
The ultimate opportunist.
Introducing the challenger from Ghana, West Africa, weighing in at 212 pounds, Kofi Kingston. And introducing the champion from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 249 pounds, he is the World Heavyweight Champion, the Rated R. Edge.
The challenger not taking their eyes off the championship.
And the champ is staring daggers right back at the opposition.
Kofi Kingston gets a great shot to become World Heavyweight Champion. He beat Edge on SmackDown 3 weeks ago. Can he beat Edge here tonight at Clash of the Champions? Edge versus Kofi Kingston for the World Heavyweight Championship underway.
Kingston out here loves to preach the power of positivity alongside his New Day brethren.
You know what? Power actually matters in there, Cole. The power of the W. All the New Day could stand to focus more on collecting wins than collecting rainbows and unicorns and pancakes. Kofi included.
Boy, I don't see how you can argue that Kofi Kingston, of all people, lacks any type of focus when the bell rings. Perhaps tonight's matchup will serve as a reminder that he's actually able to successfully multitask.
And Edge has been completely laser-focused since coming back to WWE after 9 years out of the ring. He credits his grit for his ability to come back like he has, in the shape that he has, and continues to perform at such a high level.
Corey, I would love to get your thoughts on what it'll take to come out on top against Edge here tonight.
Patience will pay dividends here.
Edge has a tendency to let emotions get the best of him, and once they do, it's only...
Is it enough? Two! A close count for the challenger.
Wow. Great evasion from Kofi.
DDT!
What a counter by Edge.
A counter answered by another counter.
These two showing how well scouted they each are.
What are we going to see here?
Oh, neckbreaker! And that may have just shaken Edge's focus.
Kofi showing some focus against the competition there. Can he maintain it?
I love that move. The champion's down! The champion's down!
Oh, my God! We're going to have a new champion!
The champ just beats the three count.
You have to think this battle is starting to weigh down on him.
You're showing on the champ.
For all things considered, Cole, it's not a...
From the top, splash! Cover! Two! No, the champ holds on.
Obviously still has some fight left.
Here it comes!
Uh-oh!
Oh, I love that move.
Win for this young man. One of the biggest in his career by far.
What a battle. Respect to both competitors.
And this I love. This I absolutely love. Maybe you should have taken a page out of that kid's book in your career, Corey. Great sportsmanship.
I would have hit him in the mouth.
What a win for Kofi Kingston, the new World Heavyweight Champion. He troubled Paradise Edge out of the title since Edge won the belt back at Money in the Bank in a fantastic match, in which Kofi Kingston is the new world champion. Wow. Yeah, dude, anytime, man. What a match. That's our night's not over yet. We got one more match for the SmackDown Tag Team titles. The Outsiders, Kevin Nash and Scott Hall, will face the Usos for the World SmackDown Tag Team titles. Hollywood Hogan will be in the Outsiders corner, the NWO, and Roman Reigns will be in his cousin's, the Usos, corner. Main event here at Clash of Champions.
It's Hall and Nash. Welcome to the Uso Penitentiary.
On SmackDown, the NWO defeated the Usos with Hogan in six. Defeated the Usos in a tag team matchup tonight. In our main event here at Clash of Champions, the Usos defend the World Tag the SmackDown Tag Team titles against the Outsiders. Will the Usos walk away tag champs, or will the NWO claim their first gold since coming back at SummerSlam? SmackDown Tag Team titles up for grabs here tonight. What a night it has been so far. And then what a way to cap off in a fantastic event. Outsiders, Usos, Tag Team titles on the line.
On the line as the World Tag Team titles are up for grabs in this tag team match. And we are starting things off with Scott Hall and Kevin Nash. And across the ring we see Jey Uso and Jimmy Uso.
The champs are not going down without a fight, but the challengers really seem ready for the challenge tonight.
I think this is going to be a dugout brawl on another level because neither of these teams want to go home without the title.
Jey showing his instincts.
Drop kick. Tags him in. Gets cracked by the overhand. Bulldog!
Hall dodges out of that.
Is Kevin Nash.
Look at this.
Off on the rope. Jimmy saw it coming.
Delivering elbow after elbow.
Whatever's playing here can't be good.
Someone called defenses.
And Jay reverses.
Kick to the gut.
Oh, brutal form.
Tag is registered.
Oh,
champ taking the worst end of the exchange. Gotta find a way to get out of this.
Oh, man, right to the esophagus.
In comes Scott Hall.
And tag, he did it.
Let's go.
Uh-oh, jawbreaker.
Call the dentist.
Oh, man.
Bam.
Super kick.
Just punched him right in the mouth. Relentless.
Enough already.
Uh-oh. Blackjack.
Way up there.
Oh, that's a shot of the jaw.
Hall running into big trouble now.
Jimmy displaying a lot of intensity. Uso.
Uso splash.
The champions need to finish the job.
Just in time.
Here's Nash into a rough landing on the outside. He catches Jimmy with a counter.
Hall looking to get back in this.
Scott knows he has an opening he needs to take advantage of.
Gets him with the counter. Reversal on top of reversal. Jimmy tied that one. Oh, saw it coming.
The face has been planted.
Here's the pin title on the line.
Here we go.
The champ kicks out with authority.
Giving a massive effort to overcome the pin attempt.
Ooh, brutal form.
This is Uso's perseverance getting tested. An arm breaker. The champ's shoulders are down.
One, two.
Kicks out.
I didn't think we'd see a kick out there.
Stiff headbutt.
The top.
Diving double axe handle. The champ in a worst case scenario.
Maybe just stay down, man. You've done enough.
Jimmy Uso is going to need to get his comeback on lockdown.
Good call. Tag is made, and here we go.
Spine buster.
Champ looking to end this.
Yes. Ref breaks the illegal pin.
Superstars' faces. Exhaustion is beginning to set in.
They're starting to breathe heavier. This is the time where matches are won and lost.
Another reversal. Eye for an eye here. He turns it around on Hall. Just carrying the opposition anywhere they want.
Are you kidding me?
Precarious position for both superstars.
Oh, gosh.
Back suplex on the apron.
He is truly feeling it right now, as well as he should.
Whoa.
Focused on in a corner. Great reversal.
Sidewalk slam with a championship on the line.
And a strong kick out in one.
Right now, I just don't know what it's going to take.
The finishing touches could be coming Jay's way here.
John Hall has got a run where he wants him. Up and
champion. Cover.
Whoa, how can that be fair?
Come on, ref. Keep these guys in check.
Whoa, bionic elbow.
Bodies have been decimated. Fortitude has been tested. And these fans are showing their approval of these superstars.
Covered by the champ.
Oh!
John Hall has got it.
aggressive counter. Oh, it's raking the back. Right to the kidneys from behind. Boom, did you hear the impact? And Jay finds himself on the receiving end again.
And giving up the hell. Still going strong here, despite the grueling toll this match is taking on him.
And embrace his presence. Press man in.
Oh, yeah. Here we go.
Suplex. Oh, Nash gets cut off. There's the tag. Perhaps thinking about what to do next here.
Oh, right to the throat. Ooh.
In off the tag.
Kick to the gut.
Right to run into a neck breaker. Makes him pay with a counter.
The electric chair down for the drop.
Out. Here we go. Jimmy going up high.
Top rope.
Got the knees up just in time.
This could turn things around.
Well, that'll do some serious damage. Listen to this place. It's electric.
John Hall has got a run there.
Just saw, I think this match is far from over. Who knows what that kick out cost? The champ might be running on fumes. It is unreal that this match is still going on after a maneuver that would end most matches.
Hall dodges out of that.
They burn an atomic drop.
Ooh.
Ooh,
man, that was nasty.
They weren't that good looking anyway. Wards off that offense from Hall.
Four.
Tough position to be caught in here.
My goodness!
And then look at that!
The ref's count ain't stopping.
The clock is ticking here.
Eight!
And here's the tag. Scott Hall into the ring.
Up to the electric chair, down for the drop.
Changed hands.
Yeah, and we had the distinct pleasure of having the best seats in the house, gentlemen.
What a match to end Clash of the Champions. The Outsiders, the NWO, hold tag team gold. What an incredible night it was. We saw Kofi Kingston win the World Heavyweight Championship. Triple H retained the WWE title. Becky Lynch winning the women's title. We saw Sasha beat Charlotte Flair to win the title. We saw The Undertaker and Kane. So we saw a lot of title changes here tonight at Clash of the Champions. It was definitely a great night of WWE action. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I will see you guys tomorrow night on Raw and Friday night on SmackDown. What will happen with the NWO? What's going to happen with the bloodline in the NWO going forward? We'll see what happens Friday. Till then. Peace out, guys. Love you guys.